busy afternoon of field events, as we mentioned at the top of the program, including the women's discus. And this is just a confirmation of how the top three reached the final three stage. Val Allman, the newly crowned Olympic champion, 62-47 she went out in round one. It was her only registered mark in the first five rounds. Then Yaimé Pérez, the reigning world champion, going out to 64-69 in round five. That was her best effort, enough to get her through to the final three. But Sandra Perković, what can you say about Sandra Perković? Well, double Olympic champion, going for a record equaling seventh Diamond League title, 66-08. The best of the lot, that came in round two. And that's how the final three earned the right for a sixth throw. So our final three, Perković, Perez and Allman, the Olympic champion, who will throw now in reverse order. I'm sure you're now by now getting used to this final three format. The best five, or the best three after five rounds, earn the right for a sixth throw. Total jeopardy, sudden death, and the winner, thrower who throws the furthest in round six, regardless of what has happened in the opening five rounds, takes the victory. So it'll be Val Allman, the Olympic champion, who will go first. Such a popular victory in Tokyo. It really was rather unexpected. And Perković just outside the medals in Tokyo. So Val Allman, 26 years old, said she started discus not for the usual reasons, but the main reason was so she could go to the annual spaghetti dinner that the discus throwers in her area had every year. Some motivation. She's done rather well, hasn't she, at the sport. Also started out life as a dancer. So, does she play it safe and get a mark? Does she give it her all? Here she goes, setting the mark then in this final three. First to throw, Val Allman. And that's pretty decent. Forget what has been thrown already in the first five rounds. Of course, the advantage that Perez and Perković have in throwing second and third in reverse order is that they know what they have to achieve to get the victory. 64-51. It's her best effort of the afternoon so far, and not a bad time to produce it. So 64-51. Is the mark to beat from Yaimé Pérez.
Well, I'll tell you what, Chris, she's excited by that, isn't she? What a time to produce your best effort of the day and throw down the challenge for the next two. Perez will be next to go. Remember, in round five, 64-69, she is the reigning world champion, the Cuban, bronze medalist in Tokyo. Persevere. She was fourth in Beijing at the World Championships back in 2015, and then 2 years later, fourth in London 2017, and then hit gold in Doha 2 years ago. What did she do here? Sixth and final round. This is the one that matters, though. Oh, that's big. That is big from Perez. Beyond 65 metres. I think it's her best of the afternoon as well. The series started very, very casually, 59-01 her opener, then a no throw, then 59-12. Then she started getting into the groove, 62 metres her fourth round, 64-69 her fifth round, and that's 65-31 for Perez. And she finds, well, almost another metre on top of her fifth round effort. Perković here just has to get it right. She's lost some of that aura of invincibility this summer with that fourth place in Tokyo. I know she's had her fair share of injury problems.
So that's the mark to beat for the great Sandra Perković. She's going for a third consecutive Olympic title in Tokyo. Didn't quite happen. Tim's right. She has lost that air of invincibility every time she stepped into the circle. Two or three years ago, victory seemed almost formality. Well, 65-31 is the target here. Perez, what can she do? Wow, brilliant. Very close indeed. Well, all three in the the final three in this women's discus have raised their game in round six. She liked the look of it as soon as it left the hand. Excellent technique as always. Has she done enough to get the victory? Yes, she has. 65-68. So 37 centimetres the winning margin. And Sandra Perković takes another step closer to quite the showwoman as well. Another step closer to that seventh Diamond League trophy.
Well, Chris, many will see that as justice done. The 1-2-3 after five rounds remain. The 1-2-3 after six rounds. Perković there, not reaching out to the 66-metre line as she had done in round two, but good enough for the best on this occasion. Nice dust-up that between the three big names. Allman, of course, has the boasting rights for the summer. The American there to the right is the Olympic champion. World number two this year. Through 70 metres at the US Olympic trials to join that select group of athletes who have broached that mark. And there's not so many, certainly not in recent years. But she will enjoy this victory, Sandra Perković, gradually getting back into the groove, and will be looking forward to throwing in Allman's backyard next year at those World Championships in Eugene, Oregon. Haven't got your tickets for that one.